if you stay tuned, I'm going to give you a sixth step at the end that is going to make everything even better and make a lot more sense. So please stay tuned. Okay, let's jump right into it. To get started, I'm going to give you step zero, so to speak, which is preparation. I really want to set you up for success. Here I'm going to use an HB pencil, but you can use whatever you prefer, even ink if you want. Now for this part, my recommendation is to look for something you are into, preferably a master's study of a painting you like, and make a simple sketch of it. You don't have to go crazy with details, just need to get the proportions right, and maybe take some notes of shadows and lighter areas, but mostly I would say focus on the proportions. In this case, I'm going to use this painting from Catherine Brico on Instagram, and I'm linking her profile on the description of this video in case you want to check her out. Okay, just a very quick word before we start painting. This method that I'm teaching you is based on the different thicknesses of gouache that you can get. If you are familiar with the oil painting rule of fat over lean, this is very similar, but this time we're going to be calling it thick over thin. Now this means that we're going to use layers with a lot of water at first, and then progressively we're going to use less and less water until we are pretty much just using paint straight out of the tube. Now for our first step, here we're going to use tea consistency. Now tea consistency is about using mostly water with just a little bit of paint. It is very transparent, and that's pretty much why we call it tea consistency. I think of this first layer as your way to get rid of the fear of the blank page. Also kind of as a warm up as well. You just want to cover your whole page with a light layer of whatever color you prefer. I've been enjoying using this raw umber kind of tone, but different colors have different effects. Now, if you're curious about the differences, you can go and check my 2023 sketchbook tour with all my gouache secrets, and there I talk quite a bit about this topic. You can see it linked on the card above here, and also you'll find a link on the description below. Now the other thing that I like of this layer, it is that we'll be working from a mid-tone, not just from the pure white of the paper, which sometimes can be not just a little intimidating, but also it can kind of mess up your values since you don't really have a reference of darkness or lightness. And now once you have covered your painting area, which as you hear doesn't have to be perfectly uniform, I suggest you just go and get a cup of your favorite beverage and let this dry in the meantime. Step two, this is going to be coffee consistency. On this layer, we're going to be using a little bit more paint than on the last one. The texture is still pretty much like water, but with a higher tinting strength, and we are starting to lose some of the opacity. The way we're going to use this consistency is to start defining the main colors of the objects in our painting. At this point, you don't have to worry too much about having perfect edges, but you can start thinking about, which areas are going to be darker and lighter. I would suggest you don't get too hung up on, too much at this point. The next layers after this, they're going to be quite a little bit, quite a bit more opaque and precise. So if there are any quote-unquote mistakes, we're going to fix them with the subsequent layers. So forget about the details and focus on the bigger masses of color. Once you feel comfortable with how you have defined the main elements, we're going to jump into stage three, which is milk consistency. At this point, you will start noticing that there is not just water in your brush. The paint is just starting to get creamier, and there is almost no transparency at all, depending on the color. And as I say that, I do need to mention that not every color is fully opaque. Some of them are sort of transparent, and that's okay. Slowly, you will learn to work with it or around it, depending on your preference. And also, not every brand is the same, so you can mix and match brands if you want to optimize for transparency or opacity. The way I suggest you to use this consistency is to start defining a little bit better all those shapes on your painting and focus even more on the values of everything. As you do so, you will probably enter what people call the, you know, that dreaded ugly phase. Many people get discouraged when they reach this point of the painting, but you just need to push through it. If things look weird to you, you just probably need to enhance those darks and brights and give it a little bit more contrast, and slowly everything will start making sense again. You can also start placing some of the details, but again, nothing too defined just yet. That would also help you push through this frustration that could be happening and get you started also with the next step. And this next step, it is step 4, cream consistency. This is pretty much how it sounds. It is the creamiest that you will use gouache, and you're just gonna be adding enough water for it to glide on the paper, and it is pretty much as opaque as it gets. As we focus more and more into the details and strategic areas, we want to be more and more mindful as well of your strokes, because at this point mistakes start becoming a little bit more difficult to fix. Now, not impossible, but they are just more tedious. So here we want to finalize dialing everything in, especially the value ranges and colors on your painting, and maybe some of the details as well, and leaving just for the end the very last highlights and textures for the thickest that you will use gouache, which is step 5, butter consistency. At this point, we're using the paint almost straight out of the tube, or with very, very little water. That's why it is not going to glide as well. But this is an advantage as well, because we can create dry brush effects if that's something that you want to go for. In my case, I use it mostly for the highlights and darker spots, you know, just for the details. So those dots of light reflected in the objects, reflections on wet areas, you know, on the eyes and so on. This stage tends to be the shortest, but it is also where you want to be the most intentional with your brushwork as well. And it usually is where the whole painting comes to life because of that. So yeah, enjoy it as much as you can while it lasts. Now that I have taken you through these 5 steps that I tend to structure every gouache painting I make, I want to encourage you to practice them and try to understand them very, very well. You know, the purpose of each stage, and get comfortable with each consistency. And once you reach that point, you can jump into the bonus step that I promised you at the beginning. And that 6th step, it is just forget everything that I just told you. Now, you might be thinking that I went a little bit crazy, and maybe, but actually not so much. It is definitely important that you learn and feel comfortable with the medium, but it's even more important that you develop your own process. So for example, I usually first do the underpainting, and then on top of it, I do my drawing, because it is easier to see. Then, not every part of the painting needs to go through all 5 layers of gouache. You can leave some with just the underpainting, or, you know, leave them at any point you like. You also don't need to finish one layer before starting with the other, as you can have different sections of your painting in different stages, and then jump into finalizing one area while the other is still looking a little bit raw. I do that especially while I wait for a section of my painting to dry. And you can even simplify this process if you wanted to. So instead of having 5 steps, you can do it in 3, or yeah, whatever feels more comfortable to you. As long as you keep in mind to always paint from a thin consistency to a thicker consistency. And finally, yeah, there are so many variations of this process, so please feel free to experiment and come up with your own version and whatever feels better to you and gives you the best results. I really, really hope you liked this video. I put a lot of care into it, so if you did, I would appreciate if you subscribe and let me know what you think about it. So please also check this video that is popping up here. I'm sure you're gonna like it. And thank you for everything. Have a good one.